弟兄姐妹，大家平安。今天非常欢迎讲英文的弟兄姐妹朋友来到我们中间。
For English speakers, welcome to Black Hawk Chinese Ministry. We are so glad you're here.
各位是否有过这样子的经验呢
？What has this happened to you?
你读圣经，你读得很起劲。
You're reading the Bible. You are going along.
有很棒、很精彩的故事。
Then you read something interesting.
但是突然有一段。
Then you read something.
等一下，等一下。
Wait, wait.
这不太对吧
？It can't be right.
神不会做这样的事啊。
Can't God do something like this?
我无法认同。
I don't agree to this at all.
圣经怎么会写这样的东西呢
？What's it doing in the Bible?
多少人读圣经有这样的经验
？How many of you have had this experience reading the Bible?
哇，很多人。
Well, lots of hands.
当圣经跟我们的期待不符合的时候
，When something in the Bible doesn't fit our expectations，
就有种很突兀的感觉。
We get this sense of this dissonance.
没有，刚刚没有举手的人。
For those of you who did not raise your hands，
我举一个例子。
I will give you an example.
以利亚是先知。
Elisha is a prophet.
是神的发言人。
That's God's spokesperson.
他代表神向人说话。
He speaks on God's behalf to God's people.
我们来读一段列王记下的记载。
Let's read the Second Kings.
各位可以看上面哈。
You can read up there.
以利沙从那里上伯特利去。
From there, Elisha went up to Bethel.
正沿路上去的时候。
As he was walking along the road,
从眼里城里出来一班年轻人讥笑他。
Some boys came out of the town and jeered at him.
说秃头的上去吧。
Get out of here, body! They said.
秃头的上去吧。
Get out of here, body!
以利沙回头看他们。
He turned around, look at him, look at them.
奉耶和华的名咒诅他们。
And called down a curse on them in the name of Lord.
所以以利沙他走着走着。
So Elijah is walking along the road.
一群孩子跑出来。
A bunch of boys came out.
他们很没礼貌。
And they just being rude.
他们叫以利沙秃子。
And they call Elijah baldy.
哎，记得以利沙他是先知哎。
Remember, Elijah is a prophet.
他就咒诅他们。
He called down a curse on them.
然后呢
？And then.
于是有两只母熊从树林里走出来，撕裂他们中间四十二个年轻人。
Then two bears came out of the woods and mauled them, 42 of the boys.
你作何感想呢
？What's the reaction?
一个可能。
One possible reaction is.
千万不要笑别人秃子。
Never make fun of bald people.
你看我也快了。
He's getting there.
我二十八岁就开始掉头发了。
I start to lose hair since 28. The age of 28.
我希望你应该有的反应是。
I'm hoping your reaction is something like this.
太过分了吧
？Well, it seems really excessive.
死了四十二个孩子，哎，青少年。
42 dead kids.
就因为他们骂他吗
？Because just they said, "Get out of here, body."
神在想什么啊
？What's God thinking?
有些人可能你现在心里很紧张。
You might be getting a little nervous right now.
尤其是第一次来到教堂的人。
Especially you are visiting us for the first time.
你想说哇
？You are thinking, "Whoa!"
这间教会里面的牧师居然在台上攻击圣经啊
！Was this church pastor talking trash about the Bible?
如果今天是你第一次来
，Now if you are visiting us for the first time,
欢迎来到 Black Hawk 教会。
Welcome to Black Hawk Church.
第一，我们非常非常的欢迎你。
First, we are so glad you are here.
第二，我不是在攻击圣经。
Secondly, I'm absolutely not up here to talk trash about the Bible.
我只是要指出。
What I wanted to do to is point out.
我们读圣经的时候遇到难题或是不认同的地方很正常。
That's quite common for people to read the Bible and struggle for disagreement with it.
今天的重点。
Today's big idea, the main point.
重点不是我们认不认同圣经。
The main point is not whether we disagree with the Bible.
是我们不认同的时候该怎么办？
Is what to do when we have disagreements.
这是我们今天要谈的。
This is what we are going to talk about.
这个讲道系列叫重塑信仰。
This series is called Under Construction.
今天是六篇当中的第五篇。
Today is the fifth week out of six-week series.
这个系列当中呢
？In this series,
我们来探讨人们解构自己信仰的一些原因。
We are looking at reasons why people deconstruct their faith.
第一讲中我说明过。
In week one, I explained.
这种过程在我们信心的旅途上很常见。
It's quite common in our faith journey.
一开始我们建构信仰。
It starts at the beginning. There's a period of construction.
就是建构。
A construction.
我们建立一个对神或是圣经的一个观念。
We build some belief in God and the Bible.
刚开始我们做基督徒的时候。
This begins early as we follow Jesus.
然后接下来我们会进入下一个阶段。
Then we enter into another phase or stage.
叫解构。
It's called deconstruction.
这是过去我们对神或者圣经的一些理解呢
？Some expectation that we have built about God or the Bible
不再有效了。
It's not working for us anymore.
所以我们就开始解构信仰了。
So we begin to dismantle it.
我们需要停下来。
This is where we go. We need to pause.
我们需要重新理解。
Then ideally we need to move to. Then we need to. We understand it again.
这时候我们进入下一个阶段。
Then we move to the next phase.
叫做重构或重塑。
It's called reconstruction.
我们得到别人的帮助。
We get some help from others.
重新打好信心的根基，让信心成长。
To rebuild a foundation of our faith in Christ.
让我们的灵命更加的成长。
Help us on our spiritual journey.
以下呢是我们看到这几方面这几个主题哈题目。
These are the topics that we are covering.
我们基督徒在这几方面经常会遇到这样子解构的这些过程。
To Christian or Christ follower, we often encounter this situation.
例如说像对耶稣说是，对基督徒说不。
For example, you know, What if I love Jesus but struggle with Christian?
苦难
Suffering.
科学与信仰
Faith and science and faith.
圣经
The Bible.
耶稣的排他性主张
The exclusive claims of Christ.
今天的主题是圣经
Today I'm talking about the Bible.
如果你错过了前面几讲
If you missed the earlier ones,
欢迎你上 YouTube 或教会网站听
I recommend you. Go check them out on YouTube or church website.
圣经是一些人解构心中的信仰的原因。
The Bible is one of the reasons why many people deconstruct their faith.
但是我先说明一点。
Before I get into that, I want to start with this.
圣经是建构信仰很核心的一部分。
The Bible plays a central role.In how we construct our faith,
圣经是我们信仰的根基。
The Bible gives us the pillars of what we believe.
它让我们知道神是谁。
It tells us who God is.
也让我们知道人类的本质应该要怎么样。
And what are human beings supposed to be?
和神透过耶稣基督为我们做的事。
It tells us about what God has done for us through Jesus.
它也是帮助我们灵命成长主要的工具。
And it's one of the primary tools that God used to transform us.
对我而言，圣经太重要了。
For me, the Bible has been absolutely fundamental and very important.
神用圣经启发了我。
God used the Bible to inspire me.
用圣经引导我走成圣的道路。
And to move forward to transform my life.
圣经实在是太伟大了。
But Bible is absolutely amazing.
我在神学院里面花了四年的时间研究它。
I spent 4 years in graduate school getting deeper into the Bible.
但是圣经里面还是有地方让人感到很奇怪。
But there are things in the Bible people find troubling.
圣经中有一些故事呢，述说神的审判。
The Bible tell story about God judging,
惩罚了整个城市跟国家
and punishing entire cities or nations.
整个民族连带受罚
people groups as collectively.
也有神命令他的子民去屠杀其他的民族
and God commanding His people to commit genocide.
圣经也有一些常常被人误来错误的引用。
The Bible contains verses that easily be misused.
来合理化种族奴役的一些经文。
And are used to justify race-based slavery.
也有一些经文表面上非常的歧视女性。
The Bible says things that on surface seems outrageously containing verses hatred against women, misogynist.
也有一些经文看起来非常的不包容其他的宗教信仰。
You may find a new, also the Bible is quite intolerant of other people, religions.
今天你发现了。
You may have found a new one today.
圣经好像过度的保护秃头的人。
The Bible seems inordinately protective of bald people.
这些都是圣经中让人解构信仰的事情。
These are big topics in the Bible and cause many to deconstruct.
会让人怀疑圣经到底是好的还是不好的。
To begin to question whether the Bible is good, is a good thing or bad.
神到底可不可靠？
Is God reliable?
当然有很多是对圣经的误解。
Well, of course, there's many of these is a misunderstanding.
例如，圣经并不支持奴役。
For example, the Bible does not really support slavery.
利用圣经来合理化、正当化奴役的人。
The people use the Bible to justify slavery.
他们曲解圣经。
They were not reading it right.
我们需要学习。正确的解读圣经。
We need to learn how to interpret the Bible properly.
我今天不一一的去对这些问题解经。
I will not be able to do that for most of these topics one by one.
因为任何一个上述的问题，都需要花超过40分钟的时间。
Well, anyway, you know, any of the above topic needs 40 minutes.
去年秋天我们开了一门课。
Last fall we had a course
叫做性与信仰
called Sexuality and Faith
花了六周总共十二个小时
over the course of 6 weeks in a total of 12 hours
探讨神为何创造性
we got into why God created sex
还有这对我们人类对性有什么理解
and what does that mean for our understanding of human sexuality
性跟我们的信仰有什么样的关系
？And how it fits into our faith？
每一个像这种的疑问都可以开一门课。
Every one of these topics can be the subject of a new course。
我们今天不一一的去解答这些问题。
Today we would not deal with specific disagreement.
今天的目的是
，What I want to do is
帮助大家更深的。思想
help us think more deeply.
这种不认同圣经的经历
about this entire experience of having disagreement with the Bible.
第一点
my first point.
圣经的某些部分你不认同，这个很正常。
It's entirely expected that you would disagree with some parts of the Bible.
不知不觉我们会有一种观念。
Somewhere along the line, we pick up an idea.
因为有这种观念
because of this idea,
我们读圣经的时候
when we read the Bible,
我们直觉的会认为
we have this intuitive sense,
所有的内容应该都是爱与平安
that everything we read in it should just be love and peace.
都要来符合我们的是非观
and everything we think is good.
然后当我们读到这些不符合的地方。
When we run into things that we disagree with,
我们就认为它不应该在圣经里。
And we think this shouldn't be there.
问题不在于圣经。
The problem is not, not the Bible.
问题是我们这种观念。
The problem is, with our belief.
这种跟随耶稣就很自然、很顺、很轻松的观念。
This belief that following Jesus should feel natural, feel right, feel easy.
一直在我们的潜意识里面。
It has always been in our subconscious mind.
在我们内心的最深处有一种错误的基本假设。
At the bottom of our hearts, there's fundamental misconception.
神应该要认同、同意我的看法。
God should agree with me.
不用每一件事情。
Not on everything.
但大致上，特别是重要的事情上。
But generally on really important stuff.
神应该要跟我一致。
So God should go along with us, with me.
因为我是对的。
Because I'm right.
我们多多少少潜意识里面都有这种想法。
We all think this way, to some degree.
创造宇宙万物的神
，The Creator God of this vast universe，
应该跟我的想法一样
，Should agree with me。
这是我们根深蒂固的
，This is very deep rooted in us。
自意自以为是
，Self-righteousness， being opinionated。
我们需要解构，打破这种想法。
We need to deconstruct， break down this idea。
我们每一个人。
Every single one of us,
我们的观点，我们的价值观
，our view, our values,
都是受世界、社会环境的影响
，are shaped by the world and social environments around us.
无论我们多么的努力
，no matter how hard we try,
我们评估事情的时候
，the way we evaluate everything,
都是受到世界的各种影响
，is influenced in all kinds of ways by our world.
对我们大多数的人而言
，for most of us.
都是受到二十一世纪美国价值观的影响。
That is the 21st century's American value.
还有华人文化跟社会的影响。
And Chinese culture and society that influenced us.
你的文化和背景塑造了你。
You are shaped by our culture and background.
圣经告诉我们。
Here's what the Bible say.
历代的所有人类社会文化。
Human culture in all times and at all places,
都是破碎的
in some ways broken,
有罪性
sinful,
有缺点的
flawed.
所以我们的观念跟价值观
which means our views or values,
都是破碎、有罪性、有缺点的
are broken, sinful, and flawed.
神对世界有不同的看法。
God has a different view of the world.
他对自己
of who he is.
对人类存在的意义
of what it means to be human.
对何谓良善、公义、慈爱
of what it means to be good and just and love.
都有不同的看法。
He views these differently.
也就是说。
Which means,
其实神在大多数的事情上面跟我们的观点不同。
God disagrees with us on most things.
当你读圣经的时候
，When you read the Bibles,
你会感到不和谐，有张力。
You feel, you should experience dissonance and tension.
甚至是冲突
，a conflict.
那往往是神在。挑战你的观点和价值观。
Well, God is challenging your views, your views, your values.
如果你仔细读圣经
if you read the Bible carefully,
你发现每一句话你全部都认同。
And if you agree with everything,
那圣经就不是神写的了。
Well, God did not write the Bible.
圣经会挑战每一个人类的社会文化。
The Bible challenges every human culture.
每一种人类的观点。
Every human perspective.
也就是说，当我们不认同圣经的一些内容。
Which means disagreeing with the Bible.
也是完全意料中的事。
It's entirely expected.
所以我们解构了一个这种普遍的错误的认知。
So we have just deconstructed this common misconception.
就是我们不应该会有不认同圣经的时候。
That we shouldn't have objection reading the Bible.
接下来我们要重塑、重新建构。
Now let's do reconstruction.
这就是我们今天的重点。
And that's get us to this big idea of this talk.
我们应该处理 我们不认同的地方。
We should what we should deal with this disagreement.
我们如何回答这个问题？
How we answer the questions.
取决于神是怎么样的一位神。
Depends on who God is.
和他为什么给我们圣经。
And why he gave us the Bible.
圣经是一个整体的故事。
Bible as a whole is a story.
我们两年前花了九个月的时间。
Well, we spent 9 months in 2 years ago.
总结了整本圣经的故事。
Summarizing the story of the Bible.
就在我们的网站上叫做《活出》这本书。
Is on our website called Live the Book.
故事是这样的：神创造了一群人。
In the story, God created a group of people.
他了解他们，也希望他们了解他。
Is the people that he knows, and he wants them to know him.
他忠于这群人。
He committed to these people.
他也希望这群人忠于他。
And God wants these people to be committed to him.
他爱他们，也希望他们爱他。
He loves and he wants them to love him back.
他称他们为自己的儿女。
He called them his own sons and children.
后来为他们死。
And eventually he dies for them.
让他们能够与他自己和好合一。
In order to unite them to himself.
他也把自己的灵放在他们的里面。
He put his own spirit into these people,
让他们有能力活出不一样的生命人生。
To empower them to live a different kind of life,
有美好的品格。
A life of integrity,
圆满健康的。
Wholeness and healthy,
爱与自我牺牲的。
Love and self-sacrifice,
谦卑耐心的。
Humility, patience,
智慧良善的。
Wisdom, kindness,
总之就是反映出神美好的品格。
In short, a life that reflects God's own character.
神呼召人们成为他的伙伴。
He called these people into a partnership with him.
一起重新修复这个破碎的世界。
On a mission to remake this broken world.
这就是圣经的故事。
That is the story of the Bible.
当你读的时候
，When you read it,
神希望你更想认识他。
God hopes you are more interested in getting to know him.
成为故事中的子民。
And become part of these people that, yeah.
你要了解。
You see.
圣经是一个邀请。
The Bible is an invitation.
进入一个与神亲密的。
Into a relationship of intimacy.
爱和委身的关系。
Love and commitment relationship.
它指引我们灵命成长的路。
It guides us on the path to spiritual growth.
让我们更像神。
To becoming more like God.
并且加入神爱的大家庭。
And living in the family of love with other people.
也加入神大使命，要救赎这个世界。
And to partnership with God on His mission to redeem this world.
关系、灵命成长、使命。
Relationship, spiritual growth, and mission.
神要的是这些。
That's what God wants.
就是跟随耶稣，就是这三样东西。
That's what it means to follow Jesus. 3 things.
圣经就是为这个而写的。
The Bible is written for that reason.
神要的关系不是一个盲从的一个关系。
It means He doesn't want.Blind obedience.
神不要我们只是闭嘴乖乖的就好。
He doesn't want us to just shut up and behave.
神希望我们越来越懂他。
God wants us to understand him more.
他要跟我们互动。
He wants us to engage.
也就是说，我们可以不认同。
Which means you can disagree.
圣经当中有很多不认同神做的。
The Bible has lots of story of people who disagree with God.
亚伯拉罕是神第一个呼召成为他子民的人。
Abraham, the first person God calls to be part of His people.
神跟亚伯拉罕说他要毁灭两个城市。
God tells Abraham he plans to destroy 2 cities.
亚伯拉罕这样子回答。
This is how Abraham responds.
创世纪十八章二三跟二十五节。
Genesis chapter 18 verses 23 to 25.
亚伯拉罕上前说：“你真的要把一人和二人一同除灭吗？”
Then Abraham approached him and said, "Will you sweep away the righteous with the wicked?"
你绝不会做这样的事，把一人和二人一同杀死，把一人和二人一样看待，你绝不会这样。审判全地的主，岂可不行公义吗？
Far be it from you to do such things, to kill the righteous with the wicked, treating the righteous and the wicked alike. Far be it from you. Will not the judge of all the earth do right?
你看，亚伯拉罕说，你这样不行。
Look, even Abraham said, no, there's no way to do it.
城中可能有些异人。
There might be a few righteous people in the city.
毁灭他们是不对的。
Destroying them would be wrong.
这是亚伯拉罕他跟神的意见不同的时候。
That's Abraham disagreeing with God.
在出埃及记的第三十二章。
In Exodus chapter
32。神说要毁灭以色列人的时候，
When God say he will destroy the Israelites,
摩西反对神，
Moses disagree with God,
而神就根据摩西的话改变了结果。
And God changed his action based on Moses' arguments.
亚伯拉罕跟摩西是很好的例子。
Abraham and Moses are good examples.
还有太多的例子，像以利亚。
There are more like Elijah.
耶利米、约拿、彼得。
Jeremiah, Johann, and Peter.
他们反对神。
They disagree and oppose God.
结果发现自己大错特错。
But at the end, they realized they were totally wrong.
圣经中很多人反对神，与神争论。
In the Bible, people disagree and argue with God.
为什么呢？
Why is that?
在旧约的子民。
In the Old Testament,
神的子民叫什么？
What's the people's God's called?
以色列。
Israel.
那是雅各的名字。
That's Jacob's name.
他长久不信靠神。
He has a tough time trusting God.
在故事里，有一天他与神角力。
In the story, he wrestled, physically wrestled with God.
他与神摔跤。
He wrestled with God.
在跟神摔跤完之后。
At the end of the wrestling.
神给他起了一个新的名字。
God gave him a new name.
以色列。
Israel.
希伯来文读 Israel.
In Hebrew word is Israel.
是由 Yisra 和 El 两个字组成的。
It's the combination of Yisra and El.
Yisra 的意思是与他与谁或什么角力挣扎。
Yisra means whom he struggled wrestle with.
El 是神。
Else means God.
以色列的意思就是与神角力。
Israel means the struggle with God.
这是神子民的称呼。
That's the name of God's people.
今天我们是神的教会。
Today we are the God's church.
我们是新的以色列。
We call the new Israelite.
我们是新的与神角力的子民。
We are new struggled with God people.
当神人跟神角力的时候怎么办？
What does God do when people struggle with him?
神来个天打雷劈吗？
Strike them with lightning bolts?
不，神不会那样。
No, he does not do that.
神与他们对话。
God engaged with them in conversation.
神给人空间时间。
God gave them space and time.
因为当人们反对的时候会开始问问题。
Because when they disagree, then when they ask questions,
他们会更深入。
They go deeper.
他们开始更了解神。
They understand God deeper, better.
他们开始以神的眼光看世界。
Then to see the world the way God he used.
然后他们会全心投入神的使命。
And they're all in God's commitments.
神要的是这个。
That's what God wants.
关系、灵命成长、使命。
Relationship, spiritual growth, and mission.
这意味着神不要我们的大脑关机。
Which means God doesn't want people who turn off their brains.
然后跟神说啊，随便你啦。
And just okay, whatever God.
我们要一步一步的更认识神，理解神的话语和作为。
We need to understand what God's saying and doing.
我先提出三个基督徒的错误。
Let me first point out three mistakes that Christ followers often commit.
然后我再提出一个更好的方法。
And then I will show you a better reason, better way to do it.
第一。
First.
相信就是了。
Just believe.
圣经都已经这么写了。
The Bible says it.
我就相信就这样。
I believe that's settled it.
有这种想法呢，源自于什么？认为怎么样？
It assumed that all God wants is like that.
神只要我们相信，然后我们就去做。
For you to believe and do the right things.
这是一种很普遍的观点。
Now I know this is a very popular view of God.
但是这种每一件事，只要你去盲从的这种关系。
But what kind of a relationship can you have if you just blindly follow it?
有什么益处呢？
What's the benefits of it?
不多是吗？
Not much of it, right?
我们想想看。
Think about it.
家里有青少年。
When you have a teenager at home.
多少人家里有青少年？
How many you have teenagers?
Okay, 一半左右。Raise your hands. 好。你要他们无条件、不经大脑的服从你吗
？Do you want them to obey you without questions, without thoughts？
有的时候是很想了。
That would be nice sometimes。
但是长远而言，我们希望的是什么呢
？But in the long run, what do you really want？
我们希望他们懂事成熟。
We hope they understand and mature。
成为健全的人。
Become a full person。
而不是一个做与不做唯一的理由。
And who do not do anything just.
我妈妈说的。
My mommy said so.
那就变成一个巨婴妈宝了。
Then we just raise some mama's boy.
神要的不是这样。
God wants more than that.
所以什么都相信就是了。
So this kind of just belief option
会大大的限制了我们跟神的关系
，limits the relationship with God
和我们灵命的成长
，and our spiritual growth。
第二种错误。
The second mistakes。
让圣经跟你一致。
Make the Bible agree with you。
有些人会说，圣经可以有很多的解释。
Some people often say, "Hey, the Bible can be interpreted in many ways, many kinds of ways."
所以就选一种自己最喜欢的就好了。
So just pick the one you like.
这个选项蛮受欢迎的。
This is quite popular too.
因为跟神不一样，有点不舒服。
Because disagreeing with God is uncomfortable.
那就把这个不舒服变不见吧。
So just make it go away.
但是这有两个问题。
But this option has two questions.
一，你不能任意解释圣经。
First, you cannot interpret the Bible the way you like.
历史上有无数的人用曲解圣经来合理化自己的行为。
Well, we know throughout the history, people have twisted the Bible for their purposes.
所以有人误解圣经。
But just that's why some people misinterpret the Bible.
不代表没有更好、更正确的解释。
It doesn't mean there are no better interpretation or right interpretation.
解经是有原则的。
There are rules of interpretation.
我推荐这本书。
I recommend this book.
圣经导读。
How to read the Bible. How to read the Bible for all its worth.
它给我们基督信仰的解经原则。
It gives some basic rules for interpreting the Bible.
教会网站上还有很多的学习资源。
There are many more resources on our website.
认为圣经可以随意解读。
It's simply not true.
是大错特错的。
So to say that the Bible can be interpreted in any way, you are totally wrong.
第二个问题。
The second problem.
当你曲解圣经，让它跟你一致。
When you make the Bible agree with you.
那就不会带来生命的改变。
There's no transformation. There's no change in your life.
你还是老样子。
You remain the same.
这严重的破坏了你跟神的关系。
This option badly damaged your relationship with God.
因为你把你的观点凌驾在神的观点之上了。
Because you put your value above God's.
第三个错误。
The third problem, mistakes.
就是远离。
Walk away.
当我们觉得圣经有问题，质疑它的时候
，When we feel the Bible is problematic, questionable，
当时又感受到与圣经不一致，好像也不太对。
At the same time, we feel this sense that it's wrong to disagree with。
可能就会觉得神在气我们，因为我们有疑问。
We feel like God is angry at us for our questions。
又觉得其他基督徒会论断我们。
We feel like that other Christians are judging us。
这种张力很难熬。
This tension becomes unbearable。
于是我们就远离。
So we walk away。
这是最糟糕、最错误的。
This option is the worst。
你变得跟神没关系了。
It leaves you with no relationship with God。
当然就没有灵命成长。
And there's no life changing, no transformation。
以上三个错误都不是神要的。
The three options above are not what God wants us to do。
现在我们谈正确的步骤。
Let's talk about the right, correct steps。
第一，放松。
First, be okay with it。
承认自己某些事与神不一致。
Be okay with the idea that we disagree with God in some area。
你认知到自己跟神有一些差异。
Indeed, by becoming aware of your disagreements,
应该让你更有动力来灵命成长。
Should give you more motivation to grow spiritually.
第二，研究分歧的地方。
Second, investigate the differences.
花时间找资料。
Look things up.
但是要记得。
Now remember.
网络上有一大堆乱七八糟的东西。
There's all kind of crazy stuff on the internet.
不要随便相信一般油管或抖音上面的频道。
Don't randomly trust things on the YouTuber
or TikTok.
Or TikTok. Or TikTok.
不要对，找可靠的资料。
Find reliable, reputable resources.
教会的网站上有不少。
We have many of them on our website.
找牧师来推荐。
Find them.Pastor here, and we'll give you recommendations.
再来找人提问讨论。
Furthermore, ask questions. Find someone to talk to.
问牧师或者是问小组长。
Go to the pastor or a community life group leader.
如果他们泼你冷水。
If they discourage you.
不要气馁。
Don't be discouraged.
再找别人愿意跟你讨论的人。
Go to another person.
第三，记得神，他想要跟你互动。
The third, remember God's want to engage you with you.
当我们很确定圣经是这样说的时候
，And this is something we just think is right.
而且我们又认为说那个真的好像不太对的时候
，And we think this really, we found something that's not quite right.
我们要记得一点。
我们要
记得一点。
We just need to remember one point.
我们还是可以跟神亲近。
We can still be close, have a relationship with God.
我们还是可以跟随耶稣。
We still follow Jesus.
为什么
？Why?
因为圣经中充满了跟神不一致的人。
Because we see all these other people.
但是他们还是神的子民。
But they are still God's people.
我们可以跟神角力。
We can struggle with God.
你反而可以找到前进的动力。
Rather, you can now find something that allows you to engage.
来加深你对神的理解。
To deepen your understanding of God.
你可以辩论。
You can argue.
但你要给神空间，让他证明他是对的。
But you need to give God space, some space to God to prove that, to persuade you.
我的个人经历是这样的。
That's my story.
我对圣经有很多的问题。
I have serious questions about the Bible.
我花了超过二十年的时间。
I've spent about 20 years of time.
我读了四年的神学院。
And I spent 4 years in theological education.
我才了解过去我不了解神的地方。
And I start reach a place where I can understand what I don't understand about God.
在这个过程中，我深入的研究。
In this process, I dug deeper.
我学习神的本性。
And I learn so much about God.
我努力的融会贯通整本圣经。
And strive to understand the Bible.
有疑问，我们就更有动力，更深的认识神。
Actually, questions drive us to.To engage and understand more about God.
神要我们跟他角力互动。
God wants us to wrestle and interact with Him.
我澄清一点。
Now let me be clear.
我担心有些人说。
Because I'm a little worried about some people is going to say this.
黄牧师，我可以。黄牧师说，我可以爱怎么样就怎么样。
Pastor Huang said, I can believe what I want and do whatever I want.
因为跟随耶稣可以跟神不一样。不一致。
And following Jesus because it's okay to disagree with God.
那不是我的本意。
That's not what I'm talking about.
记得神要的是亲密的关系，灵命成长，还有我们投入使命。
Remember, God wants a relationship, life changing, transformations, and mission.
我们也要这三样。
We should want the same things.
不认同、不一致不是借口。
Disagreement is not an excuse.
让我们为所欲为。
Not a free pass to do whatever you want.
这一点要弄清楚。
I hope that is clear.
第四，对神的爱与良善有基本的信靠。
Point number four, I want to maintain basic trust in God's love and goodness.
当我们跟所爱的人有些争论的时候
，When we have disagreement with someone you love,
我们开始重新解读每一件事。
What happened is what we start to reinterpret everything that happens in the relationship.
透过这次的争论的眼镜来解读。
Through the lens of this fight,
我们经常做这样的事情。
We often do that.
我们其实也知道。
And we know about that.
通常这样是很不公平、很不健康的。
Usually that's unfair and unhealthy.
关系并不能被一次吵架来定义，对吗
？And that one fight does not define the relationship.
所以我们跟神有分歧的时候
，in our disagreements with God，
要记得神是爱。
Remember, God is love.
他良善公义。
He's kind and just.
他认识我们，爱我们。
He knows us and loves us.
我们吵架的时候要想到我们跟神整体的关系。
We need to put our disagreement within that large. We need to put God's relationship. Remember that.
最后第五。
At last, point number five.
留在群体中。
Stay in the community.
不要单独一个人。
You don't do this alone.
在 Black Hawk 教会。
Here at Black Hawk.
我们要做一个不只是允许你问问题。
We want to be a community for allowing you to ask questions.
我们也鼓励问问题。
We encourage asking questions.
也视问题为灵命成长的动力。
And seems, and make it seems like motivate us to ask questions.
和迈向健康的过程。
And for the health of the entire church.
所以我们有各式各样的课程，还有查经班。
And that's why we have various courses and Bible studies.
我们也推荐 Upper House.
We also recommend Upper House.
加入他们的 email 通讯。
Join their email list.
他们有很多很好的讲员、作家、作者、神学家。
They have great speakers, authors, and theologians.
他们有很多的讲座可以学习讨论。
They have.A lot of gatherings good for discussions.
我们非常赞赏他们的学习心态。
We are very appreciate their learning attitude.
以下是我对教会的心愿。
That's my hope for our church.
大家都能够深深的来思考圣经的话。
Everybody engage deeply into the word of Bible.
如果你认真的读圣经。
If you seriously read the Bible carefully,
你应该会有很多的问题。
You should have a lot of questions, tons of questions.
我们要当认真的问问题。
Let's be people who ask questions.
讨论、深入学习的人。
Discuss, dig, and learn. Dig in and learn.
我们给神空间，就会更认识他。
In the process, we give God the space to help us know Him better.
让我们灵命更成长，更成为他的样式。
We become transformed into his likeness.
更符合做他的儿女。
Like his sons and daughters.
成为他大使命的好伙伴。
And we become better partners with him.
我们一起祷告。
Let's pray.
慈爱的主耶稣。
Dear Jesus.
我们感谢赞美你。
We praise and we love you.
你是慈爱美好的神。
You are a kind God.
你的智慧何其的丰富。
Your wisdom is immeasurable.
谢谢你。
Thank you.
你不计较。
You do not count our wrong.
你让我们更认识你。
You let us know you more.
哪怕我们跟你不一致的时候。
Even when we have disagreements with you.
你包容我们。
You forgive us. Embrace us.
教导我们。
You teach us.
求你的圣灵。
May your Holy Spirit
光照我们的心。
Enlighten our hearts.
启发我们。
Help us.
让真理的灵。
May the Spirit of Truth
运行在我们心中。
Work in our hearts.
让我们更认识你。
Let us understand you more.
我们把你的话语。
We put your words
珍藏在我们的心里。
Deeply stay in the heart.
谢谢主耶稣。
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
你是我们心中的宝。
You are the treasures in us to us.
我们爱你。
We love you.
感谢祷告。
We pray in the name.
奉你的圣名。
In your name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. 感谢主。